Hello students, welcome to our revision class. In our previous class, we learnt about the water bodies and the landform and also the factors that affect the human or land and water. Here, we are going to learn about soil. So this is your second chapter, and for an effective revision class, I want each and every students to gather your stuffs around, like your notebook, your book, your worksheets, for an effective learning. Students, in this video we will be discussing about the four topics. So the next part will be of the next video on your Thursday. So in this video you will be learning about the four parts, that is the four main topics of your unit. So now, shall we get into our class? Okay. Soil covers a large part of the land, not only but the plants and growth, but also the home for several small animals such as earthworm. So we know that plants are important for the existence of life on earth. Now students, can you tell me what will be so important for the growth of plants? Of course, a good quality of soil. So soil is the topic that we are going to revise. So, as you can see, soil covers a large part of the land. It not only makes the soil grow, but also for several small animals such as earthworm and insects and microorganisms too. So, we use soil to make bricks for construction and for pottery, and we add water to the soil in order to get the shape or form that we require. So that is the soil, which is important for us for the coexistence of plants and humans too. So the next topic we will be discussing about is the formation of soil. So soil is formed, as you all know, soil is formed from the rocks over a long period of time through the process called weathering. So under the weathering, you have four factors that affecting the soil formation. First one is change in temperature, rain and wind, freezing, and plants and animals. So these are the factors affecting the soil formation. So now, as you see this video, the continuous change of temperature, that is when it is very hot, the rocks expand, and it becomes cold. When it becomes cold, it shrinks. So the repeated heating and cooling of rocks causes rock crack in them. So when the rock cracks, finally what happens? Of course, when the climate is under freezing, the rock tries to break the part. So that is your second process of weathering. That is the factor. Water expands and freezes. What happens? Yes, it withers and make it into small particles of the sand. And the next one is the plants and animal exist in the rocks. But the bigger growth, they form the crack in the rock, and as they tend to become smaller particles, the animals that dig into the rock can also help them in breaking and forming the soil. So the roots inside the soil will help them to break furthermore. So the action of sun, water, ice and wind. Yes, that are the four topics. Breaks them into pieces of rocks to form the soil. And this process is called weathering of rocks. Can you understand me now? Let me explain you again. The formation of the soil, as you know, soil is formed over a long period of time, and the process are called weathering. It doesn't take place in a day or in an hour. It takes years and years to form the particles. Not only years, sometimes it takes a decade or more than a decade. Okay, so as you can see, the first one is the change in temperature. When it is very hot, the rocks expand, and when it becomes cool, it shrinks. So the repetitive action, what happens? yes, causes crack in them, and the rock finally breaks into smaller particles. Then this is not the only factor that affects the rock. After that, freezing happens, and this expand. What happens when it freezes? Water expands. So when water enters into the crack in a rock and freezes, it expands and pushes the crack further apart, and this causes the rocks to break into smaller particles. So after breaking into smaller particles, what happens? The wind, rain, and wind is also one of the particle of one of the form of it. So the plants and animals, the root of the trees goes inside the rocks. As they grow bigger, they form the cracks in the rocks and break them into smaller particles. So these combined action is called weathering. Can you tell me now? Under the weathering process, the processes are, first one is change in temperature, rain and wind, then the third one is freezing, the last one is plants and animals. So these are the topics that comes under the weathering process. Now let us see the next topic. So the next topic we will be seeing about is, now it is about the components of the soil. Okay, as you can see, the soil is made up of different components. The first one is of air. The soil has a gas. As you know, it has gases like, can you tell me what are the gases there? Yes, oxygen and nitrogen are trapped in its pore. They are used by plants for their food. Okay, so the next one is water. The soil absorbs water from rain and stores it. The water is used by the plants to prepare their food by the process is called photosynthesis. So 25% is covered by air and 25% is covered by water. So the mineral particles takes the major part in the soil. So the soil is made up of small broken pieces of rocks and minerals in the form of sand. Can you tell me the next one? Yes, slit and clay. So these are the three major components that takes place in the mineral particles. The next one is organic matter. As you can see, organic matter is made up of plants and animals, that is dead plants and animals, and small living organisms such as earthworm and so on. Not only earthworm, there are microbacteria and many other organisms present in the soil. So organic matter is made up of 5%. So this is the components of the soil. So this will be our third topic that we have covered here. And the last topic that we are going to see is mineral particles. From the starting, if you try to see in a clear path, first we learnt about what is soil, and the next one we are learning about formation of soil, and under the formation of soil we are learning about the components. After the rocks are broken into small particles, what happens? The components of soil. And in the components of soil, you have mineral particles, no? That is what you are going to learn. The next one. Yes, mineral particles in the sand. Okay, so as you can see, mineral particles in the soil are made up of most of soil, sand, and slit and clay are formed from these mineral particles. Okay, so now what you're going to do is, you are going to get along with me to learn the properties of sand, slit and clay. Here I have made you a properties based visualization so that it will be easy for you to understand here. Now look at the picture and keenly watch and come along with me. The first property that we are going to discuss here is size of the particle. Okay. So when we say about the particles size, it has big particles, that is sand. Sand has big particles. So next one is silt. Silt has the particle size smaller than the sand, but it has bigger than the clay. Okay, so the very finest particles are clay. Okay, now we have completed the first property, that is the size of the particle. A second property is size of pores. It has big pores, those are sand, and the clay has very tiny pores, and the slit has the pores smaller than that of a sand. Okay, so this will be the size of the pores. The next one is water holding capacity. So this is your third property. So under this you are learning how many properties? Three properties. First one is the particle size, second one is the size of the pores, and the third one is the water holding capacity. So it cannot hold water. So when you compare with the slit and the clay, sand cannot hold water. So it has the highest ability to hold water. Can you tell me which has the highest ability to hold water? Yes, of course, clay has the highest ability to hold water. So slit has a medium ability to hold water. Okay, when you compare with sand, slit has little higher quality when you compare with clay. So these are the three properties that you have learned, or now today you are revising again. This you have learned already, and you have gone across many tests, and here you are doing it again. You are repeating. So now when you compare the permeability, that is the bigger pore size, clay has what? Yes, of course, it has the ability to hold water. Okay, so this is how the three properties are discussed. Now let us recap all the things that you have learned from the first. So the first topic that we have covered is soil and its importance. So as you know, soil is very important for the existence of life on earth. Okay, if you want to have a life, it even includes us humans also. So if you want to have a good life, so soil will be very important. Okay, a good quality of soil is important for the plant growth. So as you know, soil covers the large part of the land. Okay, so that is the importance of the soil. So the next thing that we will be learning about is, can you tell me? Yes, formation of the soil. In the formation of the soil, you learned how the repeated process or the factors that affects the soil, that factors that affects a big rock can give you a small fine sand particles. The first one will be the change in the temperature, and the second one will be the rain and wind, and the third will be freezing, and the fourth will be animal and plants. So can you get it now? Under the process of weathering, you know, soil is formed from rocks, big rocks, not small rocks. It has been formed from bigger rocks for a long period of time. It cannot take over a day or a year to form. It takes years and years, like a 50 years or 100 years, even a 500 years to get into this part. Okay, so that will be the weathering part. So that is how the soil is formed. The next one is components of the soil. So as you know, the four main components are air, water, mineral particles, and organic matter. So these are the four main components. Okay, so under the mineral particles of the soil, we learned about the three types of soil. Okay, so here you know, air, water, mineral particles, and organic matter are the components of the soil. Now let us discuss the next topic, mineral particles in the soil. So under this, you saw the three types of soil. One is sand, silt and clay. You also learned about the three properties. Yes, first property is based on the size of the particle. Second property is size of the pores. And third property is water holding capacity. Okay students, so these are the topics that we have revised today. And as you all know, for an effective learning, you have to come along with me, watch the videos, and your exams are nearing. I want each and every students to be prepared in a well manner. So thank you students for your cooperation, and please get along with me for the further revision classes. So thank you students.